Hello students, good morning. I'm Prem Gupta, your English teacher. Dear students, in the previous classes we were discussing the grammar portion in which I have taught you already. The first chapter, that is parts of speech, second chapter, noun, the naming word, and we were doing the third chapter, that is pronoun, a noun replacing word. Dear students, in this chapter we have also discussed the definition of pronoun, in which I have told you that pronoun is a word that is used at the place of noun, that is used instead of a noun. Okay, as I have told you, suppose that any noun is there, Leela. At the place of Leela we can use she. Suppose that any noun is Mohan, at the place of Mohan we can use he. Okay, suppose that the noun is children, we can use at the place of children they. Okay, pen is the noun, at the place of pen we can use it. Okay student, so pronoun is a word which is used at the place of noun or instead of a noun. Okay, for example, Leela is a good dancer, she dances well. So here the word she is used at the place of Leela. Therefore the word she is pronoun in this sentence. Okay students, and we have also discussed there are six kinds of pronoun which is given in your book. Personal pronoun, possessive pronoun, demonstrative pronoun, reflexive pronoun, emphasizing pronoun or emphasized pronoun, interrogative pronoun. Okay students, these six are given in your book, although there are 10 kinds of pronoun, but you have to read only six, in which I have told you, I have taught you the first and second kinds of pronoun. First one is personal pronoun. It is stand in the place of people and things, and it is also stand for three persons, first person, second person and third person. Dear students, in the previous class I have taught you that what is first person, what is second person and what is third person. In the category of first person we keep I, we, us, okay, my, me. These are the pronoun are known as first person pronoun. Second person, you, your, yours. And third person, he, she, it, him, his, them, theirs. Okay, these are the third person. You have already written in your notebook, you can see from there. Okay students, so personal pronoun stands at the place of people or things, and it also stand in three person. These pronoun, first person, second person and third person. And the second I have taught you, possessive pronoun. In possessive pronoun I have told you that it shows the possession or ownership. It shows the possession or ownership. For example, this is my pen. This is my pen. So here the word my shows the possession. This book is mine. Here the word, the pronoun mine shows the possession or ownership. Therefore, these words are known as possessive pronoun. Possessive pronouns are those which shows possession or ownership in a sentence. Okay students, when I was teaching you case, in which I have taught you possessive case, okay, it shows the possession or ownership. You have written the example also, you can see from your notebook. Today we will discuss the demonstrative pronoun. Dear student, today we will discuss the third kind of pronoun, that is demonstrative pronoun. That is demonstrative pronoun. Demonstrative pronoun. Demonstrative pronoun. Okay student, just put the heading demonstrative pronoun. Before giving you notes, I want to tell you what is demonstrative. Demonstrative is demo, to show something, to point out something. Okay, there are this, that, these, those, and that. These pronouns are used to show something, to point out something. Okay, for example, we can see this. This is a marker. So here the word this is used as a demonstrative pronoun because we are showing. I am showing that this is a marker. Okay? This is a duster. Okay? This is a duster. So here the word this is demonstrative pronoun because the word this is used to point out the duster. The word this is used to point out the marker. Okay? And it shows the nearness also. We can also use that. That is a bird. Okay? That is a bird. That, the word that is also used to show something. But it is used for distance. It shows the distance. This shows the nearness. Singular and nearness, and that shows the things that is far from away, and that is also singular. And we use these denotes the plural, but it shows the nearness. And in the same way, these denote the plural, but it shows the nearness, and those also denote the plural, but it shows the distance. Okay, students, we will discuss it now. Just see here, first you will write it. What is demonstrative pronoun? Just see here, pronouns that we use. Pronouns that are used to point out, that are used to point out okay, pronouns that are used to point out the object to which they refers to. They refers are called demonstrative pronouns. Are called demonstrative pronouns. Demonstrative pronoun. Are called demonstrative pronoun. Okay, students, just see here, pronouns that are used to point out the object to which they refer are called demonstrative pronoun. Okay, students, I will also tell you what are the words. Just from the next line, you will write this, the word this, that, okay, these, and those. Okay, these words, this, that, these, those are used as a demonstrative pronoun. As a demonstrative pronoun. Demonstrative. As a demonstrative pronoun, you will write it. A demonstrative pronoun. Okay, students, just write down the word this, that, these, those are used as a demonstrative pronoun. Okay, example we can see here. Just see the example. This is दिस इज अ मैंगो. ओके दिस इज अ मैंगो. एंड हियर द वर्ड दिस इज, हियर द वर्ड दिस इज अ डेमोन्स्ट्रेटिव प्रोनाउन. व्हाई? बिकॉज इट शोज समथिंग. इट शोज द मैंगो दैट इज क्लोजर टू द पर्सन. दिस इज अ मैंगो. Here the word this is demonstrative pronoun and the word this also shows singular and nearness. Okay? And come to the next example. That is first and second you can see. That is a toy. That is a toy. It shows the distance. And but it also shows a singular object, a single object. Okay? In the same way, we can also see these are children. These, it shows the plural. Therefore, we will write here are. These are children. These are children. Okay? Here the word these. Also used to denote something, to point out something, to show something, but that is plural. And it also shows the nearness. Therefore, we have used here the word this. Okay, students, just write down up to this. And one more example I am going to give you. The fourth, that is those are trees. Those are trees. Okay, students, just see here. The word those refers to the plural and it is also used to show something, trees, and it shows the distance. Okay, students, so here this, that, these, those are used as a demonstrative pronoun in any sentence. Okay? Demonstrative pronouns are those which is used to show something, to point out something. Okay? And these words, this, that, these, those are demonstrative pronouns. Okay, students, just write it in your notebook. Okay? Demonstrative pronoun. And the next pronoun we will read. What is the next given in your book? The next pronoun is reflexive pronoun. Okay, students, I am going to erase it. Just come to the next. Okay, put the next heading, that is 4, that is reflexive pronoun. Okay, just put the heading reflexive pronoun. Dear students, if you have any kind of problem, you can ask in the comments. We have read personal pronoun, possessive pronoun and demonstrative pronoun, and the fourth one is reflexive pronoun. Okay, students, just write down first, then after I will explain what is reflexive pronoun. It reflects upon the action. Just write down. It is given in your book also. You can also write from there. It reflects it reflects upon the action. It reflects upon the action done by
बाय द सब्जेक्ट इटसेल्फ, द सब्जेक्ट इटसेल्फ। ओके जस्सी,
इट रिफ्लेक्ट्स अपॉन द एक्शन डन बाय द सब्जेक्ट इटसेल्फ। इट इज स्पॉन्ड बाय एडिंग, इट इज फॉर्म बाय एडिंग व्हाट, सेल्फ, एस ई एल एफ, सेल्फ फॉर सिंगुलर, सेल्फ एस ई एल वी ई एस फॉर प्लूरल। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, इज फॉर्म बाय, इट इज फॉर्म्ड बाय, यू विल राइट हियर, इट इज फॉर्म्ड बाय ईडी। ओके, इट इज फॉर्म्ड बाय एडिंग व्हाट, एडिंग सेल्फ, एस ई एल एफ, एडिंग सेल्फ, इट इज फॉर्म्ड बाय एडिंग सेल्फ, और वी विल एड सेल्फ फॉर सिंगुलर। यस स्टूडेंट, कीप इन योर माइंड, वी विल एड सेल्फ फॉर सिंगुलर पर्सनल प्रोनाउन एंड और सेल्फ, एस ई एल पी ई एस, इट इज, इट विल बी एडेड फॉर प्लूरल टू द पर्सनल प्रोनाउन, to the personal pronoun. Just here, it reflects upon the action done by the subject, it reflects upon the action done by the subject, and it is formed by adding self ourselves to the person, to the personal pronoun, to the personal al, okay, to the personal pronoun. Suppose that he is there, okay, we will make her himself, he himself. She is there, we will make this herself, okay, in this way. Suppose that there is they, we will themselves, S E L P E S, like this. Okay student, no need to write this, only you write up to this here. It reflects, what is reflexive pronoun? It reflects upon the action done by the subject itself, and it is formed by adding self ourselves. We will add self for singular, we will add self for plural, in which we will add in the personal pronoun, personal pronoun, you know, and we will add only self ourselves for making reflexive pronoun, because it reflects upon the action done by the subject. Now write down the action, right, example, just see the example. I spoke to them myself. Okay students, what is subject? Okay, what is the subject in this sentence? I. And for making it, it shows the action done by the subject, it reflects upon the action done by the subject. What is subject here? I. And he performed the action, therefore we have used here the word myself. Okay, I spoke to them myself. Who did the action? Subject. Therefore we use here reflexive pronoun, because reflexive pronoun reflects the action done by the subject. Here the word myself denotes that the action done by the subject, I. Okay, so suppose that there is herself. The action, the subject will be she. Suppose that there is himself. The subject will be he. Okay, suppose that there is their self. The subject will be they. Okay? So, keep in your mind, here it reflects the action done by the subject only. Okay, what are the subject used in the sentence? On the basis of that, you will use the pronoun, reflexive pronoun. Okay? Just write down this. So, here what is reflexive pronoun in this sentence? Myself. Okay, students? What is the reflexive pronoun in this sentence? Myself. You can underline it. Myself. Okay, second example you write down. He cooked the food himself. He cooked the food himself. Okay, students, he cooked the food himself. What is subject in this sentence? He. And the action has been done by the subject. Therefore, we will add here self. Okay? And the word himself denotes the action has been done by the subject he. Okay? Therefore, here we have used here himself. Just see here and write down in your notebook. Okay, students. So, today we had read the demonstrative pronoun. As I have told you, demonstrative pronouns are used to show something, to point out something. The word, this, that, these, those are used as a demonstrative pronoun. And you have seen the examples. And the next thing that we have read, that is reflexive pronoun. It reflects the action done by the subject. And we add self, S-E-L-F, or self, S-E-L-V-E-S. For making reflexive pronoun by adding self or selves to the personal pronoun. Okay, suppose that if the subject is he, the reflexive pronoun will be himself. If the subject is she, the reflexive pronoun will be herself. Okay, but dear students, in the next class we will discuss there is emphasizing pronoun, emphasis pronoun. That is also the same, but the difference is that we use this reflexive pronoun at the end of the sentence. Generally we use the reflexive pronoun at the end of the sentence or mid of the sentence. But in emphasizing pronoun or emphasis pronoun, we use that myself, himself, just after the subject. For example, I myself. In the next class, we will discuss that. But today, we have discussed the reflexive pronoun. It reflects the action done by the subject. You have seen the example. I spoke to them myself. And he cooked the food himself. Okay? He cooked the food by himself. Dear students, just write down here. He cooked the food himself. Okay, that is the correct answer. Okay, students, just revise it. And the previous thing, personal pronoun, possessive pronoun, demonstrative pronoun, and reflexive pronoun. Just revise it once again at your home. And in the next class, we will discuss some more kinds as well as exercises of this chapter. Okay, students, that's all for today. Thank you.